You have something? You want to say something?
You missed him.
No, he was the first person to get up.
Yeah,
he was the very first person. Okay, we're going to do a prayer, but I like to do this prayer a little different. Instead of me leading it or just one person leading it, I'll start it off and we all take a turn saying the prayer to touch somebody out there that's either having problems in prison, a family member maybe watching this, who has somebody in prison and their life is affected by it. And I'd like us to say a prayer that's for them. And I'll start it off and we'll just go keep on going down, okay? Dear Lord Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to bless all the men that are here right now. Lord, I ask you to bless the ones that are about to get incarcerated. Well, they're going to walk into something they've never done before. And they're going to be scared, Lord. I ask you to let your presence be known next to them. Hold them tight so they know they're not alone. But Lord, I ask you to bless their families because they just lost someone. And it doesn't matter if they're guilty or not guilty. The thing has happened for whatever reason. And I ask you, Lord, to protect the families, the children, the wives. And I ask you, importantly, to protect the individuals that are incarcerated. They are important people. Just because they're in prison doesn't mean they're any less than anybody else. In fact, they are just as important as the President of the United States himself, maybe even more so. And Lord, I ask you to touch them so they can share the gospel so somebody else will not be lost. And when we go to heaven, we can all have a glorious reunion. I ask all this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Lord, I just want to lift up just everything you do, Lord. The glory that we get to see each and every day around us. The trees, the birds, the life. Lord, I just want to thank you for all the clothing we get to wear and the bed we get to sleep on, the food we get to eat each and every day. Because there's some people out there that doesn't have it, Lord. Lord, bless those people, Lord. Lord, I just want to lift up the veterans and those stuck in prison and those over there fighting a war, Lord. Lord, I want to lift up the kids and all the families out there and inside prison. And bring them stronger and closer to you, Lord. Through their trials and tribulations, because you make us stronger through them, Lord. Lord, I just want to lift up just all those people that's not with you that needs to come closer to you, to have those around them to bring them closer to you, Lord. I just want to thank you for everything you do in our lives, Lord, because without you, we're nothing, and with you, we have everything. In your precious Son, Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Father God, as we come before you humbly, Father, we ask that you forgive us, Father, for our sins and things that we think of that are not of you, Father. We pray that you send your spirit to the people that are depressed and in bondage, Father God. We pray that you break them free, that as they go on this journey, Father God, I call it a spiritual journey, Father, because that's what it is, really. I pray that you break them down to their lowest point, Father God, and strip away all their masks that they've built and made in life, Father God, all their fake personalities and identities and something and other gods or idols, Father God. I pray that you strip them down to their lowest point, Father God, and let them realize that you are what they need, Father God, that you are all they need, Father God. I pray that they put their trust in you and their hope and their faith and their love in you, Father God. I pray that you lift them up, Father God, and fill their hearts with love, Father God, and strip out everything that has made them become what they have today, Father God, and fill them, Father God, with the blood of Jesus Christ. Let the blood pump through them, Father. Let them be fruitful. Let them be the head and not the tail of their household, Father God. Let them be the fathers and the mothers that you've created them to be, Father God. Let their eyes be opened, Father God, so they can see the truth and the light, Father God, and step out of darkness in the name of Jesus, Father God. I pray that you just bless them tremendously, Father God. Bless every step they take in this prison system, Father God. Be with them. Let your presence be known. Whenever they show their face, Let them know that Jesus is near, Father God, and that he will never back down from any fight, Father God, that he will battle any war, Father, and overcome anything that you ask him to do. Just bless them tremendously, Father God. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. Oh, Heavenly Father, Jesus Christ and Holy Spirit, Father God, we come to you right now, Father God. Bow our heads and humble hearts, Father God. Father God, through my times, Father God, of spending time behind the fence, Father God, I've seen a lot of young boys, a lot of young men come through, Father God. Even myself, Father God, at a real young age, Father God. Father God, I ask for a breakthrough, Father God.
Yes, Father.
Right now, Father God, I ask for a breakthrough, Father
God.
Father God, I ask right now, Father God, that you put your hands in the midst of this, Father God.
Yes, Father.
Let's stop all our young charity, Father God, coming through the system, Father
yes,
God.
Thank you.
Father God, I pray, Father God, you start raising up strong men right now, Father God. Father God, there's a lot of young boys out there running the streets, Father God. They're running wild. They don't know which way to go, Father God. Father God, I pray, Father God, that you just let a strong young brother, Father God, a strong man come through, Father
yes,
God.
Father.
Be it touch him on his shoulder, Father God. Let him know, Father God, that's not the route to go, Father God. And Father God, all my life, Father God, when I was out down the street, Father God, I thought the streets was my friend, Father God. But I found out, Father God, that the streets was no friend, Father God, because when times got rough, Father God, the friends left, Father God. And when I turned to the right, Father God, there was you, Father God. And I thank you, Father God, for being there for me, Father God, when my friends wasn't, Father God. Father God, I ask, Father God, let them young boys turn to the right, Father God, to see you, Father God. I ask, Father God, that you just be there for them, Father God. Bring somebody in their path, Father God. And just, Father God, to lure them away from that route that they're going, Father God. And Father God, let that breakthrough come through, Father God, that we can stop this part of all our young brothers coming through the system, Father God. Father God, because the system is not no good place for no young child to come through, Father God.
Amen.
Father God, a lot of us come through, Father God. A lot of us come out all right, Father God, but a lot of us don't, Father God. And I ask, Father God, if we can stop it at the beginning, Father God. If we can make a breakthrough at the beginning, Father God, while we're young and out there on the street, Father God, maybe we can start turning things around, Father God. I just ask in Jesus Christ's name, Father God, that you just become in the midst of this, Father God, and let your will be done, Father God. And I give all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor, Father God, to your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Dear Lord, I thank you for answering my prayers. Me and my little daughter, Lori, we were so far apart because of our love for you. You have reunited us, Lord, because she has been going to church and doing Bible study and following my footsteps. And because of our love for you, you have reunited us. And I thank you for that, Lord. And I thank you for my old friend James at Hardy that I've known for over 30 years that just got his AA in theology. And I know he's a true believer. And I pray that we'll be reunited someday because I know he has a whole family out there and nowhere to go. And I'll do what I can to help him because I've been blessed. I've learned a lot here with my Lord. It's been a long journey. But I know that this journey has just begun. It's not over. Because of your blessings, I've gotten a lot of knowledge. I know that the VA will pay my rent. And I get my VA pension when I go to work release. It's because of your love you gave me this knowledge. So I'll be secure. I won't have no feeling of insecurity anymore because of your grace and your love. And I know you're going to protect me. You're always going to be with me, my Lord. Thank you again for your love and your grace. Amen.
Amen.
Father, we come to you in prayer right now and I ask you to do something I don't deserve. I'm a sinner. I stand before you. And I ask for me and I ask for every man in this room, even when they may hear my voice, to give us faith, to give us more faith.
Yes, Lord.
We talk about a journey that we go through. Some of us are at different points of our journey. Some might be fixing to be incarcerated. Some of us are getting closer to going home. Lord, we need faith. We need faith that you've got us no matter where we're at in our life, no matter where we stand, that you've got us. We don't deserve everything that you do for us. We know that we made choices, and we know there's consequences that come to it. We ask you to forgive us for our choices. Father, just be with us. And we love you. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father God, I just want to ask you to open up our eyes. Open up my heart and my mind. Not only the women and the men that are coming to prison, but the ones that are out in the world. We all need you, Father God. There's no escape. There's no way out. I just ask you, Father God, today to lead me to you because we need you. Life is not a joke. It's for real. Those that want it and those that don't want it. I just want you to open up our mind and our heart. Give us the patience, Lord. I know I struggle every day, Lord. And I know those that are coming in and those that are out there struggling as well. But your life can be beautiful. Only thing you have to do is accept you, Father God. I just want to thank you for being a part of this meeting this evening. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, Lord, I pray that someone out there, Lord, will listen to you, Lord. Lord, I pray that you touch a soul, Lord, tonight, Lord.
Yes,
amen. That tomorrow, Lord, that soul will touch another soul, Lord, and start a chain reaction, Lord.
Yes, yes.
Lord, I just pray, Lord, for all the things that the people that are messing up, Lord, come to prison, Lord, and they say they love their wives, they love their money, they love this. Lord, I just pray, Lord, that they will come to realize, Lord, how much you love them, Lord, and that they will share their love, Lord, for you, Lord. And Lord, just speak to the young people, Lord. And Lord, I just pray, Lord, that we'll have a big reunion one day, Lord. And Lord, I just pray that all the lost souls, Lord, will find their way to you, Lord.
Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus.
Lord, I can't thank you enough, Lord.
Yes.
What you've done for me, Lord. Lord, our families, Lord, they love us, Lord. But, and Lord, I know that they want us home with them, Lord.
Yes.
And Lord, that there's no other way to make it through the system, Lord, without you, Lord. Because you just keep getting further and further into it, Lord. Lord, I thank you for what you've done for me, Lord.
Thank you.
Lord, I pray that you'll bless each and every one in this room, Lord.
Yes.
All the brothers here. Lord, I just pray that someone will grab a hold of you, Lord. I pray that they'll never let go, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, I pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, it's been a long time since I've been able to talk to people on the outside world. I've been down since about September 08, and I was 19 years old when I got incarcerated. The Lord started working in me. Every time I've gone to jail, He would send His Spirit to me when I would sit there and lay down at night, and there was no one there to comfort me, no one there to guide me, teach me. But something would always come to me in the Word of God when I sought to fill that void of, I didn't know what it was. But eventually I began to see that it was the Spirit that was working, trying to gain my trust and show that God, Jesus Christ, would always be there for me and that He was there for me. Ever since I realized that, I've been seeking His face. And coming to jail, prison, at a young age, they sent me to a YO camp, and it was real difficult there because you got a lot of young adults that, you know, really don't care because they're young and they came to prison. They feel like they have no hope. And for somebody that's trying to seek a better life and do good, that whole